Southeast hope dwindling because we are not coordinated, Igbo APC chieftain declares. A chieftain of the All Progressive Congress Party in Imo State, Toby Anumaka, has said it will fake divine intervention for an Igbo man to emerge president of Nigeria in 2023. Blaming this on lack of coordination, he lamented that when approached, top politicians in the Southeast were not ready to support anyone except but themselves. He added that this attitude has dragged Ndibu back for a long time. Anumaka disclosed this in an interview on Thursday. Like you rightly observed, I was championing the movement for the actualization of Igbo presidency in 2023. But in the recent times, my hope began to dwindle because Ndibus are not coordinated. So following the recent political happenings, it will take the grace of God for Igbo to clinch the presidency in 2023. Going by my efforts so far to get our people together, to speak with one voice, I discovered that virtually all the Igbo politicians we met, none of them is willing to support the other. Rather, they make you believe that it is either them or nobody. That is the Igbo problem, and except we deal with this attitude of I before others, our dream of producing Nigerian president of Igbo extraction will be a mirage. As we speak now, one of the prominent Igbo sons and leader whom we are looking up to as one of our best 11 for the presidential race, Senator Ojuzo Kalu, is behind bars, and just recently, Olisametu joined him. Don't be surprised that later you may discover that those who framed up this man are their kinsmen. Igbo kill their generals, and when there is a war, we will start looking for a general to lead us, Anumaka said. Alright guys, what are your thoughts on this particular news story? Is it true what Mr. Toby, or Chief Toby Anumaka, has said concerning the Igbo race? He said that Igbo race are the enemies of themselves. Igbos are the enemies of themselves because they are not coordinated and they put themselves forward before others. Guys, could this be true? Do you agree with this analysis or with this or with what Chief Toby has said concerning the Igbos? Well, be that as it may, the Igbos are actually not really coordinated or together on this particular issue, because right now as it is, a sect of the Igbos is actually standing for the secession and asking for Biafra, that is the indigenous people of Biafra, wanting Biafra nation instead of the Nigeria. Then a sect is also supporting the Nigeria, saying that the Igbos will be better under the umbrella of Nigeria. So based on this experiment, or based on this analogy that has been declared, what are your thoughts on the happenings so far? Do you think that if the Igbos come together, they can produce a president come 2023? You recall that the last general elections in 2019, Atiku Abubakar picked Peter Obi as his running mate, and they were supposed to actually have won the election, but somehow they lost it to the APC of the President Muhammadu Buhari's group. So guys, do you think that that was the best bet or the closest an Igbo man has ever come to becoming a leader or the president or vice president in this country? That is one. Therefore, do you believe that the Igbos are not coordinated and they are not together? That is two. Three, do you believe or do you agree with Chief Tony that the Igbos, you know, are self-centered because they put themselves before others, according to him, you know? He said, blaming this on lack of coordination, he lamented that when approached, top politicians in the Southeast were not ready to support anyone else but themselves. Do you agree with Chief Tony on this statement? Do you? He added that this attitude has dragged Enugu back for a long time. So, do you agree with him that it is this attitude of I before others that has dragged the Enugu back? What are the really challenges, or what are the real challenges that have, you know, hindered the progress of Enugu under the company of One Nigeria? Like you would see, you know, the issue between the Nigerians and or the Southeastern people and other region is not really a political issue, so to speak, you know, because they say charity begins at home. So if the Igbos can organize themselves at home, then they shouldn't be a problem, you know, at the national level. But all the Igbo politicians who are at the top right now, are they together? Can they actually come together and forge a force, you know, that can fight against the northern force and actually win the fight against them? That is one. Then that's another thing. Let's follow and look at what Chief Tony said. He said, going by my efforts so far to get our people together to speak with one voice, I discovered that virtually all the Igbo politicians we met, none of them is willing to support the other. Rather, they make you believe that it is either them or nobody. Could this be true? Guys, could this be true? According to him, he said, that is the Igbo problem. And except we deal with this attitude of I before others, our dream of producing the Nigerian president of Igbo extraction is a mirage, or will be a mirage. Guys, do you agree with him that until this attitude of I before others is dealt with by Igbos, then the dream of producing Nigerian president will be a mirage? Do you agree with Chief Tony Anumaka on this particular issue? To an extent, you might want to agree with him. Then that is if they all want the Igbo presidency. But as it is right now, do the Igbos actually want the presidency of Nigeria? Do they really want it? The South has been privileged to produce Goodluck Ebele Jonathan, but the Southeast have not really come close to producing anybody at the moment. So do you think the Igbos really want the presidency of Nigeria? That is one. Then two, do you really think that they can come together and put forward somebody, or come forge a force that will fight against other regions to produce the next president of Nigeria? Then three, do you also think that they have capable hands, or who can actually forge or fight this curse? Do you think that the out of all the Igbo politicians that are in Nigeria today, do you think that they have, you know, quite a good hand that can stand the test of time, and they can forge a strong leadership? So he also further said that as we speak, one of the prominent Igbo sons and leader who we are looking up to as one of our best 11 for the presidential race, Senator Oji Uzokalu, is behind bars, and just recently Olusanmietu joined him. So do you see Oji Uzokalu as one of the best Igbo politicians currently in Nigeria? Or do you think Olusanmietu stands as a viable or as a strong, worthy politician from the Igbo race? According to him, he said, don't be surprised that later you may discover that those who framed up this man are their kinsmen. Could this be true? Now, from the look of things, let's leave Olusanmietu out of this. Let's just concentrate on Oji Uzokalu. What are the chances of Oji Uzokalu? Oji Uzokalu is behind bars. Will he come out before the next election? We cannot authoritatively say. Okay, two, is Oji Uzokalu actually guilty of what he was accused and tried for? If you look at things, for me, I'm not sure. Based on the court has done their own investigation and all what have you, and came to a conclusion that he was guilty of fraud and has been, you know, sentenced to prison. So does he stand a chance? For me, no, he does not stand a chance, because he's an ex-convict at the end of the day. Then two, not just because he's an ex-convict, he actually, you know, how did he make his money? Because at some point, Oji Uzokalu was saying that, you know, he used this money to govern the state. Where is it possible? How did he make the money that he is using his personal money to govern the state? So when do we begin to, you know, see an individual, you know, getting richer than the state when he's not an industrialist and he's not a businessman, so to speak, as you know, a non-businessman before. So how did he make the money? So I don't think you know, we should believe so many of these politicians because they are not truthful and are not trustworthy. I stand to be corrected if I'm wrong. But guys, what are your thoughts on this particular news story? Do you agree with Chief Tony Anomaka on this particular assertion of his? Well, I stand to be corrected if I'm wrong. Please kindly drop out in the comment section. Let us know what your thoughts are. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Also, hit the bell icon so you can get notification whenever a new story is posted and updated. Thank you so much, guys. I appreciate your support and I'll see you under the news. Thank you and bye for now.